for invitation. I'm really, really happy to be here with you and to share that knowledge that we in Russia have been gathering for more than 25 years, actually. So today, I'm going to give you some hints, some ideas, some results of investigation of the pyramid, which we did actually in Russia and all over the world. And here, you see the questions which people mostly asked for last few hundred years trying to find out what is pyramid and what they were built for. If you go and look on this picture, probably many of yours have been traveling all over the world and you have seen pyramids everywhere. They have been built for many thousand years in different countries. They had a different shape, they had a different configuration, because this pyramid have been used for different purposes. Analyzing ancient texts and monuments, we have to conclusion that in ancient times there were at least 12 stimulus to build the pyramids. Some of the stimulus I can, you know, deeply intrigue, and I will share with you just some of these 12, because we are here a very short time. And I'll start from the moment that in ancient time, pyramids were built not by single pyramids. That was the time when the pyramid had been built by whole complexes. In ancient time, the knowledge about the pyramid have been very well spread. And all ancient text says that this knowledge have been received thousands of years ago from very highly developed civilization. And what is important that this civilization, according to ancient texts, have been extraterrestrial civilization. My personal interest was concentrated on ancient texts, because within these 25 years of investigation, I came to clear understanding. Those whom we call like monks or priests in ancient times, in reality, they have been scientists. And the knowledge which they received has a very deep and very serious impact for us. So I spent many, many years trying to filter out that knowledge, trying to understand what actually we can use for our daily life now. It's interesting when you know just the history and what actually happened with our civilization like maybe 15, 20,000 years ago. But what we can use practically now. And the pyramid investigation gave a lot of hints. And at least in Russia, it already formed the whole direction, the whole field of investigation. And we started to use this knowledge practically. And that ancient time, according to the ancient texts, knowledge has been received from extraterrestrial civilization. And this picture shows clearly, very interesting subject. Look at this. This is the beginning of the texts that explained and gave a hint to start building pyramids all over the world. And first complex of pyramid have been built from South Pole in line to the Northern Pole in spiral. To understand the knowledge, the ideas which stand behind. We should learn and we should keep in mind this ancient knowledge which called Kabbalah on. This is actually ancient Egyptian doctrine of the structural unity of the human being, the earth, and the universe. So if you know this, then you start to understand why pyramids are working, what the mechanisms are embodied in the pyramid, and what actually we should keep in mind now so that our daily present pyramid, if anybody from your family or your friends will desire to build a pyramid, you should keep it in mind. Then the pyramid will be working. So this knowledge, like in general, the most important idea says that man has physical body and seven chakras, and the planet Earth has the same principle. Human body is formed by energetic vortices with focal zones which we call chakras. The same with the planet Earth. This is the reason why the first complex of the pyramid built on our planet was forming a spiral. Ziggurats, for example, this type of pyramid performed the role of antennas for interplanetary communication. To understand how it works, here you should remember the Kabbalah on principle. One of the types of the pyramids, which I actually expose here, that belonged to global interplanetary communication system, was step-shaped. Such pyramids were built and made from metal, what is interesting, from metal, and had overall telescopic type or structure, which were steps were moving up and down, in and out, like camera lenses. The tuning of such a pyramid had based on a certain individual parameters, and I showed it here. So it is important to embody in the pyramid the distinctive biological frequency through which it is possible to reach the required Nefero. It means somebody on the other planet. This name Nefero you can find in ancient Egyptian texts, and they called gods as Nefero. So communication between Nefero or between Nefero and human took place in the form of mental images and with the help of such steps pyramids. So when someone went into the pyramid, this pyramid was moving like according to your parameters, and then you stand in the middle of the pyramid and you start to like to see visions, to receive information. And here I read the communication between Nefero and human being was in a form of like telepathic way. And here I just try to somehow explain how it looks like. I mean this mechanism of receiving of information, how you start to see a screen before your eyes, and at the same time you are getting information in the form of feeling. When you see the picture and you know exactly what was hundreds of years ago, what was going on now, and what will happen in a few hundred years, and that is giving you the whole concept of the event. Another type of the pyramids was used for very interesting purpose, receiving or retrieving information about past, present, and future. Some ancient text says, and here I'd like to point out, that there is no past and there is no future. All is going on now. To understand what it means, I made such a drawings for you, and again, we return to Kabbalah on knowledge. The universe, the man and the earth have multi-dimensional structure. How can we properly imagine this? Easily, as soon as we are working with you and using computers, this explains pretty easy. We are talking now with you about actual construction of the universe, actually the world around us. Because until we do not know this, we will not be able to understand why pyramids were built and what for they were built. If you know this, everything becomes clear. So, multiplication of realities or directories. Like we do on computer, ancient texts contain information about this natural process. So, I'll try to bring it like you. So, simply, very, very simply, when I first understood this, that the ancient texts about talking about this fact, I was a little bit shocked, you know, and paralyzed because I couldn't understand what it means. Because I remember my childhood, I am pretty, you know, grown up person now, and the time will come when I'll pass. So that was past and that was future. Has no sense. Until it was clear for me from ancient texts that we should just imagine what actually is going on in reality. Just for example, you take a computer, you have a hard disk inside. So you make a first directory, call it Earth 1. Then you make thousands of directories, Earth 1, Earth 2, Earth 3, and so on. And then in this directory, I just download a file. It can be one person or the whole civilization. And then what is important? Such division, in each dimension, time is coming with a different speed. So, in one dimension, it goes very, very slow. In the other dimension, faster. And so on. So it means that approximately in 1 hour, sitting near a computer, I have 1,000 possibilities. And then, I can make a choice. Because in our daily life, if I ask anybody of you, do you know what's going on with you tomorrow? No, no chance. What's going on with you or with our civilization in 10 years? Nobody knows about it. What you can do is just to go to clairvoyance and ask. Maybe you see something, maybe you can give us advice. Ancients, they never did it. Like all actually highly developed civilization, they do not do this. They just look into the parallel realities and they see what actually happened. And in this case, they have a choice. So, such a division, when you make a lot of different dimensions like directories, it forms a membrane between spaces, between these dimensions. And this picture shows it's very, very clear. So, such construction gives a wonderful possibility for receiving information from parallel dimension and gives wonderful opportunity to know what will happen with kingdom, with Pharaoh, with us, with Slovenia, with Russia in 1 year. So this is the very important aspect of the usage for the pyramid and gives you idea why in ancient times people spend a lot of time, a lot of, you know, resources just to build such huge complexes. Not sure for to bury a dead body. This is more than the serious, and I think you will agree that if we clearly understand what stands behind, our following next natural wish is just to start building a pyramid. Another type and another stimulus to build the pyramid was the harmonization of inner biological time to control oncological processes. And the main principle is the principle of synchronization. Ancient texts says about it, as above, so below. And here again, we see the same thing. Let's take any pyramid. This principle has been embodied in all pyramids, the most ancient ones and the most latest ones, one and the same principle. In energetical, biological, well, structure and time, human beings should synchronize the planetary energetic rhythms. I mean, we building the pyramid and embodying in the pyramid our own biological parameters, we help our body through the pyramid to synchronize our rhythm with energetical rhythms of the Earth. This is the critically important to control oncological process. Why I've started to talk about oncological process. So if anybody of you, any one of you, you go to a courses for spiritual development, and first thing which you start to do, you are starting to meditate in groups. And the teachers and gurus, they are teaching you to relax, to imagine, and to call for energy, and this cosmic energy goes inside of you. That's okay, that's great. But as soon as telephones start to ring or you stop this meditation, immune system immediately is trying to repair, to return the recent state, because when you are calling for this cosmic energy, which actually slowed down your biological time inside, for immune system, this is abnormal situation. So, when you get out of meditation, immune system immediately returns back. And then, everything will be depending on your genetic capacities. You can do it 100 times, you can do it 500 times. You may do it even 1,000 times. But the day will come when you get again into meditation, you are career, you became a career of cosmic energy. This, let's say, switch on a certain transformational processes. And then when your immune system again returns situation to a normal one, the process of uncontrollable division of the cells starts. What it means, uncontrollable division of the cells? In medicine, this process is very well known and it's called cancer. So when we made, let's say, test analysis, we just resend everywhere in all possible ways information asking, what's going with the healers in different cities, in the different schools? Those ones who practice healing or practice, well, visions or, you know, anything. What's going with them within the period of 10 years? And we came to awful result. 70% of people who honestly practice clairvoyance, healing, dead from cancer between the period 7 to 10 years. And then when we just looked on the destiny, on the life of so well-known teachers all over the world, like Jiddu Krishnamurti, Ramana Maharishi, Vivekananda, Sri Aurobindo, Mira Alfasa, all of them dead from cancer. Can you imagine, you go to the school for spiritual development and you get cancer? Wonderful results, right? Just what we wanted, I tell you. Ancient text says, the energy which you receive, you should synchronize with the energetic body of the planet Earth. What it means? So, when you go to the school, it's next slide going to be, when you go to any school and you make a first exercises, like, do you feel energy or no? And when you just started to feel this energy first, it means that your first energetical bodies synchronized, got synchronized with the first energetical body of the Earth. Good. That's good. You go on. It's very funny. It's very interesting. So you are developing yourself more and more and more, and then second energetical body of your actually structure goes into interaction with the second energetical body of the earth, and this opens for you so-called astral plane. People start to see universe, sacred Maria, Jesus Christ, you know, Arshtar Sharan, whatever, endless story. Everybody are amazed. You go on deeper, and when your third energetical body goes into resonance or synchronized with the third energetical body of the earth, you get cancer. This is the key moment. And ancient texts, which actually have been translated from ancient Egyptian to, well, Russian, and actually already published all over the world, says what you need to do is not to synchronize your energetical bodies one by one, first, then second, then third. You need to synchronize first, second, and third as one body, at once. Oops. Then, as ancient text says, you step over the border of death. So, first thing that we tried to do, we tried to make an experiment, scientific experiments in the pyramids, and to find out what actually is going on with the pyramid, how the energy of pyramid is influencing human body, human energetic structure. And here one of the results, pretty simple experiment, because the other experiments are pretty complicated. But for us now, this experiment shows a lot. So, here you can see the Mechnikov Vaccine Research Institute of Russia, it's situated in Moscow. Study of the influence of the pyramid on general immune reactivity of organism. All experiments were carried out on several groups of mice that were placed in the pyramids. Experiment shows extreme growth of cellular immunity and humoral immunity. Now I explain what it was. We had two groups of mice. One group, control groups, we didn't expose to the pyramid. The other group have spent in the pyramid 12 days. And then the deadly bacteria, Salmonella typhimurium, have been introduced in their bodies. So, usually when Salmonella typhimurium is introduced to mice, 100 of them are dead. Among those mice who have been in pyramid, 40% stayed alive. So it means pyramid has a very strong anti-cancer effect. And this proved actually and showed us what ancient text was talking about. Another experiment. Similar picture was observed when the mice were injected with various, you know, very deadly cancerogens. Mice in the experimental group drank water expelled in the pyramid, just water. The control group drank ordinary water. The results showed that the probability of tumor developing in control group was several times higher than for the animals that drank water exposed into the pyramid. Experiment proved the water exposed in the pyramid has strong anti-cancer effect. So, here is the explanation and description of the idea, one of the 12th idea, why pyramid have been built, and that those pyramid who has flat sides, they have a very strong anti-cancer effect. Little bit more interesting, very interesting results of investigation. Viral Research Institute, Russia, Academy of Science, study of the effect of the pyramid field on the antiviral activity of immunoglobulin. The immunoglobulin was dissolved and in distilled water and tested at two concentrations, interesting. Here is very interesting result. 50 milligrams per liter and half milligram per liter. Vena globulin in both concentration was exposed in the pyramid. Then, vena globulin was introduced into the cell cultures 24 hours before they were infected with the virus. The study revealed that vena globulin at the concentration of half milligram that usually has no protective effect on the cell after exposition in the pyramid did acquire an antiviral effect that was more profound and pronounced than the preparation with a 100 times greater concentration. Even from here, it's clear that pyramid empowering the healing effect, even medicine. We immediately saw that there are many, many ways how to use this effect, even with those one who offer, you know, very terrible diseases, and when the medicine is just killing their organism. We can just slow down the concentration, and just exposition in pyramid gives a possibility to empower the effect of the remedies. But what is interesting, after the exposition in the pyramid, any remedies has very strong immune-stimulating effect. Under further dilution to the concentration, 1,000 times less and 100 times 1,000 less. With subsequent exposure in the pyramid, the vena globulin displayed a pronounced antiviral effect. The antiviral activity of vena globulin practically ceased to depend on the concentration. Isn't it a wonderful result? In parallel with this, the experiment was conducted to examine the influence of water exposed in the pyramid on blood coagulation. The result showed a significant decrease in coagulation time. So if effect which we have got from our experiments showed that the pyramids will play very important role in the future of medicine. So, right afterwards, we understood that pyramids are giving us a very important chance. Chance to use the effect, the field of the pyramid for medical purposes. But at the same time, this ancient text gave us a very important hint and idea of necessity of synchronization human energy structure with energetic structure of Mother Earth, let's say, because it's really interesting that in all ancient texts, it's clearly said that, and they show the planet as the women body. And as long as each woman here knows that when you have a child and something going on wrong with your child, you feel it by your heart, even your child, if your child at home or you are at work. And opposite, if something, you know, has going on with you in the office, child immediately feel it because this connection is very, very close. The same with planet Earth, because not any kind of, you know, extraterrestrial, somewhere experimental, you know, what people say, some scientists, you know, created the human being. No, planet Earth created this form of life. So we are kids of planet Earth, and planet Earth is thinking, living organism. That's why all text says we should live in harmony with our planet. Beside it, I just wanted to give brief information that ancients also used some tools for synchronization, because as long as you saw pyramids is contracted the way so, the whole seven layers, seven energetic bodies of the human being used or take it in account when pyramid is built. So we have seven energetic structure and physical body, the same with a pyramid. So when you make a project, you're supposed to build the physical body, and the whole internal construction should be, you know, done according to the same principle. But ancient text also says that if you synchronize first three energetical bodies with first three energetical bodies of the earth, you step over the border of death. Pyramid synchronizes all seven bodies of a human being with all seven bodies of the planet Earth. So-called, and you remember, all ancient sculptures or figures, you know, of an ancient Egyptian priests, they have strange tools in their hands. I think you already saw it, or you can go take a book and you will see. That instrument, which was called like the Wands of Horus, it helped to synchronize first three energetical bodies of the human being with the first three energetical bodies of the planet Earth, at the same time stimulating hypothalamus and hypophysis, which is very important aspect. And also they used the insoles with copper and zinc inserts, stimulating first energetic chakra. So this is the reason why, if you take any books, you will see the pharaohs of Egypt, they have strange tools on the hands, on the head, on the legs. Mayans, Sumerian, all that very developed civilization, they used these tools by one important reason, because we are not able to control these processes mentally. Because sometimes when I was attending different conferences in different cities and different countries, I have encountered one and the same thing. When teachers say, well, we are so developed, you know, we have those, you know, wonderful abilities, so what we need is just take a stick, something like from the ground, take it in a hand, imagine that this is the Wands of Horus, for example, and everything is done. No, forget it. Because ancients, they were not stupid. And if it would be possible to stimulate immune system, to control the oncological processes with the help of small pyramids, why should they build so huge pyramids, spending 20s of years, a lot of resources, money, anything? Because it is impossible to realize by different way, only like this. The other very interesting stimulus for ancients to build the pyramid was described in Sumerian texts. And this text contained an information that the complex of pyramid have been used to slow down aging processes. And here is also a very, very important aspect. What means to slow down the aging processes? When we receive, or you read any Eastern tradition or whatever, you know, you have heard about existence, so-called yin-yang energies. That's all right. In ancient Egyptian, they called the same thing like Baka. But it's not only like female beginning or male beginning, plus and minus. Important aspect is missed, that Baka or yin-yang, it's two encountering flows of time. Time, one flow of time is speeding up inner biological time. The other flow slowing down biological time. So, if you put these two flows in harmony and keep these flows in harmony for at least 2 weeks, the other phase or stage begin, so-called conservation of inner biological time. And from this time, or from this moment, you can live 100 years, 200 years, 300 years, and it is going out very clearly from ancient texts, because if you start to read, you learn that ancient, they lived pretty long, 600 years, 900 years, somebody was living even more, and science, you know, like Egyptologists or the others say, oh, probably ancients, they were a little bit, you know, out of understanding, and they had their own strange calendar. No. As long as you see, and you will see later on, ancients, they were scientists of a very, very high level of knowledge. And the texts, which we actually are reading, are giving us information about reality, that in reality, if you build complexes and you control inner biological time, you can live here longer. And remember, from the beginning I told that those from whom ancients received this knowledge, they were extraterrestrials. So they came here on our planet, as ancient text says, and that people, that Neferus, they were living among people. They were talking on one and the same language. So when they landed on the earth, they get out from their energetic systems. So it means it will immediately affect aging process. And this is the reason why they advised to people to start building the pyramids here, also for one reason, to organize, to create a special zones with, like they call Timun, the land of life, with the possibility to control the inner biological time and to conserve the inner biological time. It's just a picture that says energy field inside Timun has a harmonizing effect. This is some translation from the ancient texts, conserving inner biological time, and as a result, slowing down aging processes. In legends, in ancient legends, ancient Sumerians, such place, they called these places Tilmun. In translation, it means the land of life. Tilmun were built to create conditions for conservation of biological time. And also we can read there that rare fortunate earthlings got to visit Tilmun and later spoke of them as the place where human begin obtain immortality. And here another very small example of how pyramids are affecting our body biological structure. For the period between 3 and 21 days, a 10% solution of table salt, just table salt, that had been exposed in the pyramids was added to Mithas' daily drink water. And 3 times per week, the animal were dipped, you know, like swimming, in the same solution. It emerged that the solution from the pyramid considerably reduces the effect of stress, a very important aspect, stress. The indicator of this was the quantity of lymphocytes in the thymus gland, which is known to fall sharply with the stress. The mice that had drank the salty water from the pyramid and been dipped in it showed that almost no stress they had experienced. So it means that pyramid field has very deep and strong anti-stress effect. And here, this very specific experiment, that's why I just decided to show to you also, because on one hand, it's very, the pyramid effect have been used not so strong as usually, but at the same time, we have got this interesting result, and I am sharing this result with you here. So, we studied the influence of 40% glucose solution given internally and distilled water applied externally after both had been exposed in the pyramid. The patients were newborn babies with serious pathologies. An objective assessment was provided by an analysis of the immediate state index, which reflects the state of the patient's sympathetic adrenal system. Data on 20 patients was analyzed. In all cases, even in patients with very low index, close to zero, after administration of one, just one milliliter of the 40% glucose solution, the ISI rose substantially, practically to normal effect. The same happened after the external application of 1 milliliter of water that had been exposed in the pyramid. It is more than serious result. Another one more stimulus why pyramid have been built is the to damp seismic activity. Very unusual. At the beginning, when we found out an explanation of this effect in the text, where we have been in a little bit weird situation, because how it is possible? Because, you know, the planet Earth is a huge organism and a small pyramid standing on top. So we started to make any possible tests, experiments, and even in Egyptian pyramids we did those experiments, and we came to strict conclusion that pyramids really, they have effect slowing down seismic activity. This is the map of our future 20, 30, 40 years. What will happen on our planet? And here you see the zones. Red zone, this is the zone of high instability for the following, as I said, 30, 40 years. Yellow zone, zones of relatively high instability. I mean seismic instability. Ancient instrument tradition, usually, when we go to them, they use so-called needles, right? Remember, at the beginning of our presentation, I pointed out this very important knowledge called Kabbalah-on, about structural unity of the human being, the planet Earth, and the universe. So again, we return to the same thing. So, Eastern monks, they use needles. They apply needles in a certain acupuncture point to get off pain, disease, to stimulate your inner, energetical activity. The pyramid, and it's all here, it has a very strong energetic vortex in the middle, working as energy lens. There is a matter, the pyramid generates, and as the funnel concentrates and amplifies cosmic energy in a certain frequency or range. Interesting was, when once we have received a report from military, which were based on a distance 60, 32 and 30 kilometers away from the pyramid that were built between Moscow and St. Petersburg. And they showed us that they were watching continuously this energetic beam over the pyramid. And this energetic beam was fluctuated. But what is interesting, this energetic beam was not transparent on the screen. So, this is the picture which we did. Once when we made our experiments in that pyramid between Moscow and St. Petersburg, I was driving with my friend back home on the car, and when we moved away on a distance approximately 40 kilometers, I just got out of the car and made a picture. And later we saw that on the picture there is this energetic beam. It was 1,200 meters high. And here, approximately 500 meters, width. It's a very, very strong, energetic, let's say, like a needle. So here we understood the idea. So if you place or build pyramid on a certain energetic place, like focal point or acupuncture point on the body of the planet, then you can affect the energetic processes going on under the ground, sometimes on a pretty big depth. So, if the complexes of pyramid will be arranged in a different places, special places, then it is possible to control the seismic activity. And this picture shows it very clearly. You see, all ancient complexes have been built in the zone of high seismic activity. Because when you look at it, when we first look at it, we said, it looks like ancients have been crazy. Why they build the pyramid in the middle of seismic activity? Because all pyramids will be destroyed. No, all pyramids, they were not destroyed and they were affecting the seismic activity. So here is another stimulus, why they build the pyramids. Here the most interesting thing, I tell you, the most which we also filled out from the ancient texts. A certain type of pyramids have been built as the tool to capture a spirit. This example, for example, the pyramid of China, this pyramid from Siberia, and such kind of pyramids you can find in Mexico and many other countries. Here is the text. This rhyming written text speaks openly of gods having sexual relationships with the earthly maidens. The result was the birth of children with unusual genetic abilities, described in legend as half gods. And here is another text also from the Genesis that Nephilim were on the earth in those days and also afterwards when the Son of God came into daughters of men and they born children. And that children actually, that was kids with very unusual energetic, nervous and other physical capacities. And that kids became later on the rulers of many, many countries like Sumeria and so on. Actually, this is the beginning of the blood which started at that time, and some of them, some, just very few, going up till now. But I showed this to you by a very special reason. It will help me to explain what it means to capture spirit. So now, well, okay, Daria, I'll take you, okay? So I'm your father from the other planet, and you are my daughter here, daughter with unusual abilities. She's a queen of a certain area. And I say, okay, Daria, it so happened that in 10 years you're gonna pass away. What you should do, you should build a pyramid. And when this pyramid was built in a certain place, according to certain principles, and you will die, your servant should take your body into this pyramid, and this pyramid will make a copy of your hologram. Then your body should be burned out. Then, next step. Approximately in 200 years after your death, a child will be born somewhere in Slovenia. And I give you exact place where it will happen. I said, it's going to be family, and the child will be a girl. The people whom you will prepare now must take this child and bring this child into this pyramid. So when the body will be, when this child will be taken inside, this child will remember everything. You will remember all your lives that was before, now, and you will see the future. All ancient texts said that was the people with unusual abilities. They could see through the earth. They could see everything going on in the sky. They could see north, south. Well, actually, this is the moment of real enlightenment. So in all ancient teachings and scriptures, the information of importance of knowledge where people have died is very, very, you know, like pointed out. So if you find the place where you died, and you know exactly the time where you died, and you will visit this place, that's going to be like switch off, or switch on. You will immediately remember everything, your spirituality, your sensitivity, everything grows out, and you have a quiet, new special capacities. Actually, you will be the person number one in, among the others with whom do you live. So this is another very important aspect why pyramid and what for pyramid have been built. So this stimulus to capture the spirit for the further enlightenment. And here, step by step, I'm coming to other type of the pyramid, the other stimulus why the pyramid have been built. That was mostly used by extraterrestrials. So, again, if we imagine our body, physical body, or body of the planet Earth, again, I'd like to point out, remember, body of planet Earth. Later you will understand why I'm talking about it. And actual universe, we have one and the same structure. So in the universe, there are also so-called energetic channels and so-called acupuncture points. Usually, when you look into the sky and you are wondering, you are fascinated by the form of the spiral, this myriads of galaxies or solar system in the galaxy. Now, remember, each solar system, it is a small acupuncture point in the body of the universe. And between these acupuncture points, there are so-called energetic channels. Very, very short way to fly, because extraterrestrials, they do not fly. They make a step through so-called multidimensional gates. In most remote area, highly developed civilization, with the help of
what we call now UFO, but actually it's just a spacecraft, they can go there no longer than for 1 minute. But to make this step, you need to know the map. Actually, now we have a map of acupuncture points, and they have a map of acupuncture points of the whole galaxy. And you need to know these channels. Which channels to which organ or to which solar system is moving. So, one of the most oldest type of the pyramids have been used as the navigation marker.
For UFOs. So here, very famous pyramid in Visoko, and one of the ideas, one of the reason why the pyramid in Visoko have been built, because this pyramid have been built and used as the GPS marker. So why it is important? As already you start to understand that when you go through the channel, for example, from one dimension to far, far remote area, you need to know exactly where you will find yourself. Then, there already should be pre-installed a certain equipment which gathers information from surrounding and then sends this information, for example, to me. Why I must know it? Because when I jump there and interdimensional gate are opened, my spacecraft, like appear here, I need to know the pressure of energy field under me. If it's going to be a mistake and the pressure under me, actually this energetic pillow will be weak, then my spacecraft has nothing to stand on. And immediately UFO crashed. So this is why all ancient civilization and present, I mean extraterrestrial civilization, they used the system of GPS markers, and they are using it now for very, very specific transition from one dimension to another, to a certain place, and at the same time, We are gathering, they are gathering information from surrounding, and at the same time, they are slightly influencing the people who are living around. Why it is important? Because mostly such pyramids have been built by hands of people living around, not by extraterrestrial. No, people did it. They just were giving advices how to do it. To give this advice, you need, you know, equipment, the other things. So they were teaching. So the pyramid is the source of energy, source of knowledge, and a certain source of, it's a special kind of energy to which any human being should be prepared. And here, I will try to explain the idea of the tunnels, which are situated close to the pyramid in Visoko. So, again, pyramid in Visoko contains inside a certain equipment which gathers information and transmits it somewhere into space. This is a technical device. We are human beings living here. So our body should be prepared. How ancient were advised to do that? Here you have the same principle. Again, human body. Human body has so-called blood circulation system and so-called energetic bodies, seven energetic bodies. If you imagine the energy system of human being like seven playing card, you know what I mean, playing card, like or transparent playing card. If you take just first card out of the others, you see, this is blood circulation system. But this is a kind of skeleton, energetic structure, which flesh is growing along when the child is growing up. So our energetic structure or our blood circulation system appeared not by, you know, case, because blood circulation system is repeating exactly the energetic channel system. And if the blood is carrying different, you know, stuff inside, like biological water and many, many, many other substances there, the energetic channels, they are vibrating. One like piece of energetic channel, like for example this one, vibrates with one range of vibration, then division, another vibration, another. You see a lot of different vibrations. And when these vibrations are affecting their biological liquid, this liquid, which we call blood, starts to behave itself very unusually. So this is the most important mechanism to control all inner genetic and the other processes. So here you see just a picture how in the middle of the screen these channels are moving. Oh, sorry. This is the skin. We just made a cut, cross cut. This is the surface, this the blood circulation system, and this is the earth. The same, you see? Blood like energetic channels. So remember, if energetic channels are vibrating with a different vibration, they are giving a different important capacities to the blood. So if you take out from here in the ground soil away, inside of these channels, vibration will start to influence human body by a very special way. Can you imagine what a wonderful those people were who started just from the surface and then feeling how this channel is going on, which way, down, right, left, they were moving out the soil. So when you go into the tunnel, a certain, you know, part of the tunnel is starting to affect you like energy channel is affecting the blood. This is the way when you move through them of preparation of energetic system, physical body of the human being, then to come into the pyramid of sun. Isn't it an amazing technology? Up till now, you know, I said to Sam, I would be more than happy to spend at least 1 hour with that people to learn more from them how they did it. So from here, just briefly, I can give you the most important idea about the pyramids. Then, as the result, for more than 20 years investigation, we can say that the pyramid is the powerful cosmic antenna. Then, a model in stone of the energy structure of the human being and the universe using lattice energy mechanism. A very powerful generator of cosmic energies operating on various planes. Pyramidal energetic structures whose position should be decided with a reference to the energy qualities of the location open up the following possibilities. Tapping into the natural flow of cosmic energy in the organism and stimulation of the evolution processes in the biosphere and the human consciousness. So, with the help of the pyramid, we are getting very important energetic vortices, cosmic energy. But this energy should be synchronized with the energy body of the human being and the planet Earth. Then it opens up your abilities. If you don't do this, the result is cancer. Second, correction of the human energetic structure, making it possible to stimulate internal energetic, biophysical, and psychological processes, which in turn provide the opportunity to discover and activate the inner resources of the human psyche, increasing psychic potentials. This is the reason why ancient priests really had unusual abilities. Unusual. So, if we understand how it works, it's time for now and for us to use this knowledge for practical purposes. Third, a positive influence on a human immune and nervous system, leading to their improvement. If you ask any doctors, is it possible to improve immune system or nervous system? They said, no, impossible. Ancient says, possible. And this is the way. An improvement of mankind's energy ecological environment. An increase and improvement of the energy state at the pyramid location. As a consequence of the spread of pyramidal structures throughout the world, a reorganization of the planet's energy structure within the next 10-15 years. The time will come when pyramidal energetic structures may play a decisive role in the fate of new generation. Another very interesting example. 3 years ago, when I was talking with my friends, and Sam, my friends know this case because I'm amazed by this case. I like kids, you know, kids. For me, everything. So, it was an 8 years girl, so naughty, so noisy, oh my gosh, when we have been talking together, she has been climbing on me like this all the time, no chance to concentrate. So, very energetic. So, we decided that's the time for her maybe to change a little bit situation, because we are specialists, we are talking on, it's an ongoing conversation when we meet each other about pyramids, their effects. Actually, we planned already to build the whole complex of pyramid in Russia. So we said, let's make it, let's try. Why not? Warum nicht? So we installed in this home a few pyramid. The pyramid was like approximately 2.5 meters high with energetic sources inside, some energetic sources under her bed. And then I said, try to find anything which she likes or you want. Maybe painting, maybe dancing, maybe music. They said, music. Okay, then in the form of game, starts to game with this child to show her how it's nice, the music. So, in 2 years, this girl became the best piano player in Russia. She played with all most famous orchestra in Europe. Can you imagine? 2 years, pyramid effect for kids. Amazing effect. We must use it for our practical life. So, this is the moment when we understood that beside this knowledge which we filtered out from ancient texts and the experiments which we did in the Russian Academy of Science, we, by the way, also find out that it's another science is growing up out of it. And this science has direct connection with the human body. It looks like that our body is something absolutely amazing, an individual. And the effects which we actually noticed during our experiment showed that the reaction of each human body is very special. And the secondary reaction of the pyramid depends on the reaction, first step reaction from the human body. So this is the beginning of a quite new science. And for us, it was the key moment when we said, okay, let's go on, let's stop talking, just let's build the pyramid complexes. And we made a proposal. And here, right in the middle of Russia, you know, this is the Russia, huge country. From this side of the country to here, 12 hours to fly. So right in the middle, there is a city called Tomsk. So I have got a phone call from one man 2 years ago. She called me and said that he read my books, and also he investigated my website and said, I have a proposal, can we meet? So we met in cafe. And he said that he's living in Tomsk, that Tomsk has about 1 million people living. And he said, do you aware that in Tomsk we have 600,000 students? 1 million people, 600,000 students. And he said, is it possible with the help of your knowledge, with the help of the pyramid, to create environmental, to stimulate their, you know, creative capacities, creative abilities. I said, this is something. I said, okay, sure, I will be happy to make it. So he bought the huge land 15 minutes away from Tomsk. This territory is a huge one. So here you can see the middle pyramid of the complex, which actually already built. On this picture, you can see This territory is approximately 225 hectares. So here, I have combined all knowledge which I have filtered out from ancient texts, from ancient pyramidal complex, Mayan, Chinese, Sumerian, Indian, Egyptian, everything. I pulled everything together so that we could build something that has all special, you know, aspects of all other pyramids. Because just one important idea, investigating the pyramid complexes everywhere in the world, I came to a strict conclusion that in ancient times, the knowledge about the pyramid was the one, just one knowledge how to build. And then it was tiered up in pieces. So we find one piece in China, one piece in Egypt, another in Sumeria, and so on. So here, we will try to pull all together. And we started to build this first middle pyramid. So this pyramid, this is the first one. Around this will be 32 pyramids more. And all these 33 pyramids will be connected to each other with the help of a very special energetic source. It's an absolutely amazing system. I'm sure that if I would live in the time of Cheops Pharaoh, I would be among them, and they would be happy to invite, and we would do this. Because I tell you that as the person who knows who is what I'm talking about, okay? The Cheops pyramid is a wonderful example. Huge one, great one, not perfect. This pyramid is working only 49 days per year, and then the pyramid is silent. Here we're building the pyramids which will be working 365 times per year. So here you see, we started and point out white quartz. It is critically important that the body of the pyramid should contain white quartz. I'm just giving you very fast, briefly, the stage of construction processes. Here we use, as I told you, all possible information. Also information about properties of different materials and different minerals. Some of the minerals are speeding up the inner time or the flow of time. The other are slowing down the flows of time. So even here, when we made this thing here, on one hand, we did it to keep the water under the pyramid. On the other hand, this material will help to speed up the flow of energy go into the pyramid. Another phase. So we see here eight-sided, platform. Eight-sided is important because, remember when I was talking the pyramid in between Moscow and St. Petersburg, and it was 1,200 meters high energetic beam. This energetic beam was fluctuating like this. It's a natural effect. For example, at the day of high solar explosion, like magnetic explosion or magnetic storm, this beam will disappear immediately. There is no any energy in the pyramid. To maintain this energetic vortex, it is necessary to build the base in a form of 600, like platform, 600, sorry, six-sided platform. Then it helps to keep the energetic beam more and more stable. This is very important knowledge I'm sharing with you. So on the six-sided platform, then we built 12-sided platform. And we started to build like a foundation, 12-sided foundation. It is also a very important aspect. If you go to any place, sacred places, like power places, whatever, where energetic, natural energetic beam is coming out, remember, inside of this sacred energetic place or energetic power, always there is a certain energy which is negative for us. This energy, this aspect should be cut off. And they did it with the help of resonators, which had a 12-sided form. And these parameters between width and height in a certain way, it cuts this negative aspect of energy. So it helps inside in the pyramid to get a very positive stimulating effect. So you hear. Here you see, the walls are ready. And then we started to polish walls because the preciseness of geometry should be very, very high. So the difference between this site and the other sizes was no more than 3 or 4 millimeters. We did it so precise. Because from the point of view of the principle of resonance, it's important so that the pyramid or anything would be constructed very, very precisely. This is the quartz which we put in the middle of the pyramid, and this quartz crystal, huge one, is standing on top of the energetic system which we created, we built under the pyramids. About these energetic sources, also important, I think, information for you, that in ancient times, each pyramid had energetic source, but later they were removed out of the pyramid. There is only one pyramid where energetic source stayed. It's a Cheops pyramid. That's why Cheops pyramid is still alive. All other pyramids mostly are dead because energetic sources have been removed out of the pyramid. Here in this complex, we buried the whole system under the pyramid, so it will be impossible to take it out. It's in the construction, there will be so-called oracle chamber with this huge pyramid inside. We started to build the roof here, and this is for ventilation, so that the air could go from 12-sided foundation through the pyramid and then out, ventilating the pyramid. You see, these sides are also black for the same reason, to pump energy vortex in the pyramid with a higher speed. So now, when you go into the pyramid, you feel like, you know, like water. You know, your head starts to, you know, kind of a compression inside of your brain, energetic compression. This is the area inside of the pyramid. I mean, inside of this 12-sided basement. This is a 3D model of the pyramid, of the future pyramid. We showed this walls transparent, and you can see that inside of the pyramid there are many, many chambers, which also has a pyramid-shaped, you know, structure. This is the pyramid without walls, so you can see how it is constructed. The parameters of each level pyramidal chambers are in a certain step between each other, so they are resonating, so that on one hand each floor of the pyramid has its own energetic capacities, on the other hand they are empowering each other. So the cross section from the bottom of the pyramid up to through the second floor, third floor, we have like an empty area, like a tube, so that the energy beam could go through the pyramid without any interruption. And here we started to build the pyramid, the pyramidal body by itself. Here these chambers, which has a pyramidal shape form. Here also in the middle, in this place we installed energetic sources. So we everywhere used this metallic structure so that the body of the pyramid could have a very perfect, you know, surface. Here we started to polish already pyramid. We just taking in account that Siberia is a pretty cold place. Sometimes in winter it's minus 40, 45, so we need to have a special cover, like a paint, special material, which could survive in such, you know, reality. So here we were experimenting with the different materials. And here the pyramid is ready, you can see. This is the pyramidium which we put on top of the pyramid. It is critically important for the quality of the energy. The quartz crystal pyramidion must be installed on each pyramid. And this is another part of energetic sources in the middle of the pyramid, in the zone where we registered the effect of slowing down the inner biological time. We installed this quartz ball, and you see it's 108 kilograms in weight and 42 centimeters big. This is the biggest quartz ball in the world. Inside, this is the second floor. We hang a bronze ball. bronze bell, sorry. It is also important. In Christianity, bronze bell played a very important role. Actually, in Eastern tradition too, you could see probably visiting Nepal or the other countries that they used this bronze bowl. It's done for one reason. If you stood under the bronze bowl and then somebody just clicked it, it synchronizes the vibration of each cell of your body. Ping, like one. It have been done for synchronization and for cleaning. So if the bronze bowl will be used periodically in the pyramid, then this pyramid will be always clean. Why I'm talking like this? Because pyramid, if it's built properly, pyramid is kind of an energetic accumulator. And now imagine, what kind of energy Cheops pyramid have after this hundreds of years of usage for tourist purposes. Millions and millions of people with their problems, illnesses were there, and all these ill energies stayed there. In ancient times, they knew about it, and they used so-called whistling system. You remember these channels which goes out of the king chamber, probably you know about it, and the queen chamber. In many texts, investigators, they claim that they played a role, you know, whatever. But in reality, they played two roles. First role, they have been pointed on a certain place of the sky. On top, on the entrance, on the surface, there have been installed special crystals, which were transforming the energy coming from outer space in this channel in the range acceptable by human consciousness. Then inside of each channel we have, even now, the mirror system, which when the beam goes, then reflects, then goes and reflects, and those stone blocks, actually, they play the role of mirrors. It's one thing. And then, if these crystals were taken out and the wind was blowing right in direction of the site, this channel became the role of whistling system. So pyramid started to sing a song like whoom, and this vibration helped to clean the pyramid on one hand. On the other hand, you should always keep in mind that in the times of pharaohs and priests, only a few people were working in the pyramid. This pyramid was not for tourist purposes. So here we took in account these capacities and we installed the bronze bell for two reasons, the same reason, for synchronization and for cleaning pyramid. Here in the middle you see this huge quartz bowl. From here goes water on him, and then underneath there is a system like a basin, so water goes on and return, just like gathering and accumulating energy. This is oracle chamber. Inside there is that huge crystal. This cross section says that on the first floor of the pyramid here and here, we use water. So water is running there around, and then we take this water out of the pyramid to the channels and to the basins where kids and people living in tombs could come and swim and play during the summertime. This water, as you understand, plays an important role also for the human health, and you remember the results of investigation in Russian Academy of Science. And at the same time, another very important aspect, as soon as the pyramid have been used as the tool to receive information, we should take another very important quality of the water. 50 cubic meters of water is more than enough to keep in this water all information about any living creature, about any bugs, about anything, about, you know, chemical or physical or energetical process coming into people's body from the beginning of our planet until today. So, this is the reason why water have been always used in all complexes, temple complexes, pyramidal complexes. And the reason, first one, to read information from water. Okay? The other very important reason. When the pyramid is built properly with all energetic sources, the power of the pyramid is so high that we, investigating this effect, recognized a reaction of the immune system. It means immune system started to defend against this very strong energetic influence. Oh, we said, oh, holy moly, what to do with it? On one hand, we understand that we need this energy stronger. On the other hand, the immune system starts to react, to defend. So, to bring this power into the range, as I said already, acceptable for human organism, we need to use like a transformer of this energy. Water plays wonderful, perfect role for this. So if you have water inside of the pyramid and outside of the pyramid, then organism just opens up and energy which pyramid is generating goes very, very deep and wonderful effects are starting. That's important moment, water. That's why we are keeping and will be having water here continuously. So here you see the pyramid is ready and the pyramidion is on top. The first experiment in the pyramid, we bought this very cheap wine from France. We exposed it for 12 days and then invited French specialists. You know, they came and the staff just tested and said, "Are you kidding us?" Said, "What's going on?" Because inside of this simple box, the wine is cheap. Wine is perfect. It must be very expensive. Why did you do it? We have been smiling and said, "No, it's one of the same wine, but we just exposed it, this wine in the pyramid. The effect was profound." And at the same time, we also noticed, if you take the wine exposed in the pyramid and then you drink a little bit more than normal portion, you will never get headache, never negative results, quite opposite, stimulation of immune system. You go up in the morning with a very bright, head, feel yourself quite well, and you go up not at 8, approximately at 5 o'clock in the morning, very refreshed. This is a very good, let's say, reason to start drinking. Yeah, another very interesting effect, amazing. This man, his name is Dmitry, and he was the chief of all construction company. But he is 45 years old, and he was having very high, very strong level asthma. He was using terrible, type of three, four times per day. And once when we built the pyramid, the investor also came and said, "Listen, I have got a present from India. I have just got a parcel. Inside there is a seashell, big one." He said, "I asked my friends in India to make me like a tube and to whistle through it." So we came down to the pyramid in this red chamber, oracle chamber. We have been standing there, three of us, and Vladislav, he just made a sound. That was, I tell you something. The pyramid starts to vibrate so strong. Dmitry, this guy, became absolutely white, sweating, fall down on the knees. His eyes was as if he saw in me a dinosaurus. So like this. And then ran out of the pyramid. Next day, he stopped using anything. He completely healed his asthma. Completely. One shot, just one shot. Very interesting effect. And here you can see how the whole complex of the pyramid will be looking like. So 33 pyramids, main in the middle, and this is mirror reflectors. It's approximately 200 meters wide and 12 meters high from all sides. It means that the energy along these channels, which are emitting by pyramid, will be returning back. And by this way, we're going to amplify the energy of central pyramid, and here effect will be amazing. So another picture. We actually started to build pyramids, even for some people who ordered the pyramids from us. This pyramid, exactly one, we used as the model, the first experiment we reproduced in this pyramid. This is another type of pyramids we actually started to plan, because some companies, construction companies in Russia, they invited us and asked our help to generate a certain model which they later can sell for people in Russia. And here you have just idea how it looks like. You see the place for meditation. So this particular one won a first prize in a competition in Russia for Siberia. So here somehow I came to the end of my presentation, because my actual presentation about this subject is 4 hours. But I was asked to cut it at least half. So I tried to give you and to share with you some results of investigation of the pyramids in Russia we did for last 25 years. And I hope I made it well and clear for you. So from this moment on, you see, the pyramids are more than worth to take attention. And from my side, I'd like to point out that the pyramid in Bosnia is a very, very good chance for us, because it is reachable. There are many pyramids like this which played the role of GPS marker on planet Earth, but they're in so far situated or remote areas, they are not reachable. Here, you have a perfect example. The system for preparation, for healing and transformation. From my side, I'm absolutely sure that some years will come, maybe 5, I don't know, maybe 10, but Visoko will play a role of a real spiritual center of our planet. And I will not be too, you know, excited if in the nearest future some clever head will decide to build a kind of institute there for kids, because the results of people studying there will be amazing. So here I'd like to say thank you for your attention, and I hope that I was not too boring for you. Just thank you, my friend. Thank you.